go! All right, once again, over on the red side of the field, it's Cal Poly Slow. And on the blue side, we've got BLRS2, the Purdue Sigbots. Purdue sending those tri-balls over towards the blue side. They've already got three in the direction of that goal, including that mash, that blue-colored tri-ball, Alliance-colored tri-ball. Now with 27 seconds left on the clock, the 24-inch bot from Gearslingers has stopped introducing match loads, and it's got a big pile of tri-balls behind it, and it's going to push over towards the red offensive side. Purdue introducing some more match loads, bowling those down the alley over towards the blue offensive zone where they're worth 2 points apiece. And with 10 seconds left, Gearslingers with a huge score into that red goal, but Purdue coming to try and do the same. There goes BLRS2 with another big score into that blue goal. 2 seconds left in Auton, and that's going to be the timer. So many points once again scored in here in the autonomous period. Like I pointed out last time, blue will get the autonomous bonus, and we're going to resume with drivers in 3, 2, 1, go! And finally, we are off in finals match number one here in the VEXU World Championship 2024. Let's see what kind of action we can have underway here on the Eden Field. 1:05 on the clock, and BLRS already making quick work of that blue goal. A huge stack of tri-balls in front of them, trying to get that second blue Alliance color tri-ball scored as well. 55 seconds, Gearslingers with that green bot. That's their 15-inch robot. They're trying to score in the side of that red goal. And we also have a steal attempt by Cal Poly Slow's 24-inch bot. They're going to try and drive it all the way over to the side of the red goal, but Boilers with their little 15-inch bot trying to play defense, but the red side able to get that in for 5 more points. 35 seconds now. Boilers trying to steal a tri-ball from that red match load zone, but now red able to get in position, but Boilers able to steal another one. We've got only 26 seconds remaining here in the driver control period. Cal Poly sending their robot over with one more tri-ball into that red goal. Boilers trying to introduce a match load, but Cal Poly trying to make that difficult for them. And now it's just 15 seconds left on the clock. The elevation zones are protected. We'll see who can get up in the sky. Boilers, they've got their hook right in front of the elevation pole. Can they pull themselves up? Cal Poly with both robots off the ground. And wow, what a high hang by Purdue. 2 more seconds. Let's see if the Sigbots can get a second robot off the ground. And I think they do as well. So look at how full these goals are. Look at how high these robots are off the ground. We might only have one red robot off the ground, but we'll wait for the referee's official ruling here. All right, Grant, what did you think in that match?
I thought it was worth the wait, honestly. It was just about building tension, really. No, it was the thing that was most incredible to me, honestly, was the autonomous portion. Again, you saw the Boilers able to, able to run an incredibly consistent auton, not just once, twice, but 3 times. It is the amount of difficulty and work that has to go in to make it that consistent and that, you know, precise and repeatedly through different conditions and whatnot is just incredible. And then when it all the gloves came off for driver control, everybody sprung into action. Those teams knew what they were doing. We went for a super high elevation. Both of the goals are full. Like, this is going to be a high-scoring match. So, speaking of VEXU and the various, you know, challenges and then high-scoring matches and whatnot, I am joined here by one of our long-term competitors. Why don't you introduce yourself? Tell us where you're from.
Hello, I'm Matias Broney. I'm from Central Florida, and this is my 10th year of VEX Robotics.
10th year of VEX Robotics.
Over a decade now.
Over a decade. That's crazy. So tell me about your journey as you've gone through, you know, like, where'd you start?
Started in Cypress Ridge Elementary School with an IQ team. Competed for multiple years. Went to middle school. Did school teams, private teams. Had a lot of success. And then moved to VRC with Team Jelly. That was so much fun. Now doing VRC or VEXU with UCF, and I'm having a blast. Driving has been so fun. My teammates have been incredible, and it's just working together in this university level has been just an outstanding experience.
Absolutely. So you're in a unique position because you've experienced essentially the whole continuum of VEX products as it existed as you went through it, right? So how did the jump from IQ to VRC go for you? Like, was that a challenge? Was it help? Did you feel that the IQ work, you know, helped you get started? Talk about that.
Absolutely. So one thing that carried over really well was driving, and I felt like I was an incredible driver at the beginning, but my robots
felt like I was a pretty incredible driver.
Hey, my robots were terrible, but thankfully I had great mentors. Blackout Robotics helped me get started, and with their mentorship, I became one of the, well, in Spin Up, we were the highest ranked VEX or VRC team, so that was super, super exciting.
Yeah, so, and I love it because, you know, I've talked a lot about the Auton side of VEXU. We've gotten to see a lot of the Auton side of VEXU. Yeah. How about driving in VEXU? You keep mentioning you really enjoy that side. You've been performing very well. How intense is VEXU compared to, you know, the lower end programs?
I think it's just as intense as VRC is. And I've actually learned a lot from Logan on 229. Together we've been able to learn driving strategies and use that in our matches. So unfortunately we lost today in quarterfinals, but I feel like I had some of the best driving I've ever had.
Absolutely. Make sure to check out those matches, see some skilled driving. Is there anything else, any shout outs you wanted to give? You mentioned, you know, your team members have been amazing this year.
Yeah, Arc Robotics actually has a partner hang. And not only could it partner hang with their 15-inch robots, but they did it with both our 15 and our 24, and that was awesome. That was
here so at Worlds. Cool. That happened.
That was on a practice field.
Oh,
yeah, last night.
I need sick. To find that video.
I got a picture.
So we didn't end up having any partner climbs in the dome. Did you tell me about that partner climb experience? Getting to do that with alongside another team.
It was so cool because it felt like they had a universal partner hang. All we had to do was push up their intake, drive onto their 24, and that thing just winched right up. It was super cool.
So for those who are, you know, maybe new to the program, what he's referring to when he talks about partner climbs, we've seen lots of robots climb the elevation bar, you know, off the side or off the horizontal. They developed a system, or you got to experience a system, where you actually climbed on a partner or on another robot. And so this is actually news to me. I haven't heard about this. So how high did it get? Was it able to get up to the J tier or like?
It wasn't J tier, but it got very tall. Unfortunately, with our 24, it slid down the pole, but with the 15, it stayed really, really high. I'd say it's like E maybe.
Well, if you liked partner climbing, you might want to stick around for a little bit later.
All right.
So until we get there, I believe we're ready for Tyler. Tyler, take us away.
That's right, Grant. The results from round one of the VEXU finals are in, and that match belongs to the Innovate Division. And